Hello dear students, today we are going to cover up our second chapter from the book Flamingo, class 12. It's all about stories from stolen childhood written by Annie's Junk. Some of the important facts that often are overlooked, because these are two anecdotes revolving around two separate students, two separate children. And it's all about abject poverty that these children from the very young age are pushed into. So let's try to understand what about the central theme of it. This central theme revolves around poverty. It revolves about certain traditions. It revolves around the concept of child labor. Of course, yes. It talks about exploitation. When we talk about the sahukars, when we talk about middlemen, this word sahukar, though looks Indian word, this is what Annie's Junk is specifically used some Hindi words in this particular chapter by informing that the children are pushed into the child labor. And it's chiefly because of these middlemen, these sahukars. Now let's talk about migrants from Bangladesh, right? Dhaka, do not forget to mention about, right students? You will identify that they have left the green fields, rivers, and they are left with nothing to eat, no grain. It is all about these storms that have destroyed their lives once when they were in Bangladesh, when they were in Dhaka. Then what happened, students? They migrated to Simapuri. They became the migrants to the place Simapuri. And where is this place located? This place is located in the outskirts of Delhi, specifically East Delhi. Let's try to understand theme. Second point I explained you is all about the migrants from Bangladesh, Dhaka. And after leaving Bangladesh, Dhaka, they moved to a place called Simapuri, which is located in the outskirts of East Delhi. So what I said you, what I informed you, I am writing here, outskirts of Delhi, right? And a phrase is mentioned there, near yet far. What does it mean? It means that it seems to us that they have come to a place where they can fetch out certain important things, but yet those things are so far away from them. Far is actually symbolically explaining that they have unfortunately no water in taps, dear students. They have no proper sewage where they are staying. Proper drainage system is missing. They have no identity. There is no identity, but there is a big but in between, and that big but says that they are the migrants who now have at least a ration card. They at least have a ration card, and now their name is mentioned on the voters list. Right, students? Now we are going to read about the story of Sahib, known to be Sahib-e-Alam, so far as the beautiful name that this boy is having, which means the Lord of the Universe. But once when you are going to find about him, you will find that this boy is crouching something